There are countless cages here. They're filled with skeletons. They look like packs. After they'd executed the pack's leaders, Monroy's people started moving into the city. So this was their colony. They took over the homes of the packs, forcing them to work for them, to serve them.
In other words, they made them slaves. They believed the loss of their machinery was the packs' fault.
Doesn't matter what they believe. There's no excuse for enslaving another race.
There's got to be hundreds of dead packs here, executed, piled up. This whole city is a mass grave.
Monroy's people, they did this.
I think it's getting real clear who the packs were scared of, who they changed themselves into ferals to protect themselves from.
Thank you.
This place, it was a slave market. Seems like they got hit by the worst storm yet. Hundreds died, humans and packs. Some of the obelisks were damaged too, so whatever the packs once were doing to control the storms, they couldn't do it anymore. He feared an uprising, losing control, as packs started to abandon the city. Nikolai Galiatkin. Monroy made him general and put him in charge of weapons production.
No doubt the same weapons the Ferals used against them later.
Monroy. His palace is covered with flags, all with... It's gotta be his face. He made himself king of the packs.
A king?
A tyrant. Courtyard's clear. Monroy was sending out raids to hunt down the fleeing packs. And that's when the uprising he'd predicted finally found him. But it wasn't the packs. At least, not as he expected.
The Pharaoh. He never saw them coming.
But Monroy didn't retreat. That asshole dug in. Out there in the desert, and tried to track them down, where they were coming from. That's when he found the canyon and the great obelisk. He finally understood there who the Ferals were. That's when he got word that the city was under attack.
And so it was the beginning.